Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another foiling fun video. Today I'm going to play with two plays that have just been released. This is from their fall collection by Spellbinders. This is The Leaves, a row of leaves, which is called Autumn Leaf Border, and The Sentiment that is called Stylish Script Thankful. I have a white panel that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to create an inked background. For that, I'm combining different colors of Distress Oxide inks, and my favorite color combination when it comes to fall is Spiced Marmalade, Twisted Citron, Fired Brick, and of course, Vintage Photo. I'm using all these colors coming from one edge, and I'm not going to go all the way towards the other edge. I just want to have lots of color on one side, and this is where I'm going to add the foiling. Now the other side is going to stay just plain vintage photo. But in any case, this is a great color combination to create colorful fall backgrounds, so you can use these colors to cover up completely the background and add any focal point that you like on top. Now I'm going back with my vintage photo, and if you ask me, I think this is the ink pad from all my Distress inks that I have been using again and again. I'm doing just a little bit more blending on the colorful area of my panel, and now I'm just going to fill in the rest with brown. I have been using for my blending my blending brushes, smaller and bigger, depending on the area that I want to cover. Now I'm going to add some water, just a few splashes here and there. I'm going to leave that to react with the ink. I'm going to use my kitchen roll and blot all the excess water. And you can see the lovely effect with all those splashes that I get. It actually lifts the ink from the background. Now I'm going with this copper foil, and I'm going to place the plate of the leaves on the side where I added most of the color. So I have my background, the foiling on top, pretty side up, then the plate, and I'm going to secure everything down with washi tape. I have learned this the hard way. It's always better to secure all those layers together with washi tape before you place them on your platform. Many times when you try to remove the platform from the machine, it kind of moves, so it's better safe than sorry. Once I get the indication that my plate is nice and warm, I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine, and now we can lift the foil and see together what we've got. This is always a lovely process. I absolutely love when I get to peel off the foiling and see the results. I think it looks so pretty, and notice how all those leaves pick up the color from the background. Another way you can get similar results is to first foil and then do the blending, so you know better where you want to concentrate the different colors. Now I'm going to do some more foiling on the same panel, again using the same color of foil and my sentiment. And of course I could have done it previously with one step, foil both of these plates, but for this card I didn't have a plan from the beginning. Most of the time it's like that. I just go by the flow, see how the first step looks, and take it from there. Now this is where I decided that it would look really lovely if I follow the outer edge and cut it out. So that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm using my scissors, taking my time and being quite careful. I'm leaving a little bit of a border, I'm not cutting directly where that foiling is, which makes this process easier than it looks. This leaves a decorative border on one side, and you can have your cardstock underneath. I love the contrast with brown underneath or black. It works with any color of brown, darker or lighter, as you can see. You can use greens underneath or yellows or even dark reds. Just because we have all those blended colors underneath the leaves, it is really versatile. So I'm just showing you here the process. Usually this is what I do. I have a bunch of cardstock close to me, and I just place the panel on top, try to decide what matches perfectly. This was one of my favorites, and dark chocolate was great as well. But in any case, I decided to go with this brown. I have foam tape at the back, and I'm going to stick those panels together. This way I end up having some decorative edge, foiling, and dimension. So I'm super happy with how this one looks. If you want, you can use a very small blending brush and add more color on some of the leaves. This doesn't have to be precise as long as you don't get outside of the lines. And I'm not going to overdo it, I just wanted to show you that this is a possibility. I added a few copper gems on some of the leaves and I also foiled the flap of a matching envelope. Here are some close-up photos on my fall foiled card. You can find links to everything I used down below in the description area. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.